Cubase can look very intimidating if you're new to it. Lots of buttons, lots of info. Luckily, you can simplify the interface until you can only see the things that you want to use. And as a beginner, that can look a little something like this.
Cubase is built out of different sections. Toolbar, status line, info line, channel, left zone, the project area, right zone, the lower zone, and the transport bar. And if you go into the Mix Console, Studio Mix Console, there's also a toolbar, left zone, the mixer, and the right zone. And you can customize all of these sections. You can even completely remove some of them. So let's jump in and start up here. Just right click somewhere on the toolbar, and I'm gonna uncheck some things. You can pause the video if you need to. And down here you can save this as a preset. I'll call this one simple. You can also show all tools or reset to the default. What I kept in here is the state section, just because it's useful when you, for example, soloed a couple of tracks. Then you can click this one to undo all the solos. This is auto scroll, which means the project is gonna move along when you hit play. But when I zoom in and start editing here, you can see auto scroll got suspended. If you then click this, you're back on track. And you can also switch to a stationary cursor. These are all of your tools for selecting, drawing, cutting, and so on. If you really want to declutter the toolbar, you could leave this one out as well, because these are available on right click. This is your color palette, so you can click a track and pick one, or click an event. This button kind of comes with this section, so here you can turn your snap on and off. Now when I move this event, it's snapping to the grid. If I turn snap off, I can just put it anywhere. And if I choose relative snap now, it's going to keep this relative position to the grid. If this snap to zero crossing is activated, this happens. I'm just going to make a random cut here. And if I zoom in, you'll see it cut right where the amplitude of the waveform is zero. So if I cut this out, you won't hear a click here. This is the quantize section. What you're going to use this for the most is to choose the size of the steps that you're going to move your events with. By default, and I'm just going to make this one visible again, the grid type follows this quantize setting. We're just going to leave that the way it is, so grid type can go again. And for example, if I choose 1/16th, it's going to divide the bar into 16 parts. And 1 is the entire bar. And then these last buttons we're going to put to use immediately. These activate or deactivate zones or windows, the channel, the left zone, the lower zone, and the right zone. For now, let's just keep the channel. This has your basic information for every track. You can also right click in here, set up sections, and I would keep these. Routing, which is this, the input and output of the channel. Inserts, which are your plugins. Sends, in case you want to use an effect track. And here the buttons you'll use the most are mute and solo, the panning slider, volume fader, the record enable button to arm the track you're going to record on, and the monitor button so you can hear the input when you're recording. So let's go back up. This one's a status line with info about the project and the audio connections. If you need that info, you can also go to Studio, Audio Connections, and to Project, Project Setup for the rest. So we're going to clean this up here by clicking this button, set up window layout, and uncheck the status line. I'm also going to go ahead and uncheck the info line, which gives you more info about the selected event, because it might look a little confusing. So that's gone. Then this is our main work area. What you can do here is remove some of the buttons on the track headers according to what you need. Click this little cogwheel. This menu gives you the option to customize the track controls of all these different kinds of tracks. Let's focus on a regular audio track for now. On the left you have the hidden controls, and on the right you have the visible ones. I'm going to keep the track name, record enable, and monitor, and the rest I'm going to shift click and click remove. If I click apply, you can see it changes. You can also see that these two are in the same group, group number one. That's just a visual thing. I can ungroup them, and then it looks like this. You can make them switch places. And you can also save it as a preset. And then on the bottom, we have the transport bar, which you can also right-click. And here I'm gonna keep the punch points, transport controls, time displays, tempo, and click. And now you can choose to show more or less of these tools by dragging these three dots. The punch points are not basic, but if you're going to be recording, it's very useful to punch in. So let's activate punch in and punch out. And now let's say I want to re-record this part. So I'm going to drag my locators, drag the cursor back a little bit. Make sure this is armed and you're hearing yourself. And just hit spacebar to play. And it recorded a new take over that one. Let's go back here, the transport controls. Go back to start, activate cycle, stop, play, record. This indicates where you are in the project. Here you can set your tempo or tap it. And here you can activate your metronome. So this should be a good starting point for the project window. If you go to Studio, Mix Console, you can do a similar thing. You can turn off the left and right zone. Right-click the toolbar. You can start off keeping just the state buttons and the zone controls. And to configure what you're going to see in this mixer, go here. Or right-click somewhere in here. Set up sections. And then I would just keep channel name, routing, inserts, sends, and fader. After you make all these changes and close Cubase, it should go back to your latest settings next time you open it. But in case something goes wrong, you can save everything as presets like I showed you. And you can save the window layout like this. Go to Workspaces, Add Workspace, give it a name, keep it set to Global. And if you ever have to use it, it'll be here.
So I hope that helped. If it did, please like the video and also subscribe and have fun making music.